We are going to look at the following problem. Determine the minimum value of minus x plus 2y over all values for x and y satisfying the following constraints: x squared plus y squared less than or equal to 5, x plus y greater than or equal to minus 1, and x has to be an integer. There is a simpler way to write down this problem. That's what we're going to do. So we're going to write this in a different form without that many words. So we're minimizing, so we'll say min minus x plus 2y subject to these constraints. This is the form that most optimization problem will appear in. We don't need this big stuff up there anymore, so let's get rid of them. So how do you tackle a problem like this? We have all kinds of weird constraints. We are trying to find the minimum value of minus x plus 2y subject to all these constraints. Well, the first thing to do is we can just try to sketch the set of x, y satisfying these constraints and see what they look like. And then we'll move on from there. Let's get our x, y plane in here. So let's work on the easy constraint first. We'll look at x plus y greater than or equal to minus 1. Well, remember that the way we draw these inequalities is first we draw the line defined by x plus y equal to minus 1. And that line, as you can see, goes through the points 0, minus 1 and minus 1, 0. So the line defined by x plus y greater than equal to x plus y equal to minus 1 is this. Now, so all the points satisfy x plus y greater than minus 1 will be over here, over on this side of the line. Well, because the point 0, 0 satisfy this inequality. So that takes care of that. Now, we're going to look at the first constraint. If you look at x squared plus y squared equal to 5, it's just a circle of radius square root of 5. A circle of radius square root of 5 is about 2 point something. The radius is 2 point something, so it's not going to exceed, it's going to exceed 2 but not quite 3. So if we draw this circle, it will look something like this. Alright? But we're interested in the points that are less than or equal to 5. Okay, x squared plus y squared less than or equal to 5. So we're looking at the points that lie inside the circle. Alright. But remember that our points have to satisfy the inequality x plus y greater than minus 1. So we're not looking at everything within the circle after drawing these two inequalities. The set of points satisfying these inequalities is the shaded yellow region. Okay. The last thing we have to worry about is this thing, x being integer. X being integer means x cannot be a fraction. And if we look at the points within the circle that has integer x coordinate, they are along these vertical lines. So they can pass through the point minus 2, 0, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 2, 0. If we're looking at points that satisfy all these constraints, they will be these points here. And there's one point here. So what's that point? That point there is minus 2, 1. So among all these blue points, actually, this is not quite right. So the points are here. Right, so the blue points are the points that satisfy all these inequalities. Alright, so among all these points, we want to find one that minimizes minus x plus 2y. Well, how do we figure that out? Well, let's see. We can ask ourselves the following question. Can minus x plus 2y be 0? Okay, for some x, y satisfying all these constraints. Well, of course it can be 0, because if you plug in 0, 0, 0, 0 is one of these blue points, and it gives a value 0 for minus x plus 2y. Right? There are also other points that give 0. For example, if x is 2 and y is 1, that also gives 0. And 2, 1 is also one of these blue points. In fact, if you draw the line minus x plus 2y equal to 0, this is what you get. So this is the line minus x plus 2y equal to 0. Now the question is, can we get something smaller than 0? Okay, so we know that there are points, blue points, that give me x minus x plus y equals 0. But can we get something even smaller? If you look at the point, say, 2, 0, so x equal to 2, y equals 0, that gives a value minus 2. And not only that, that point is also one of these blue points. So if you look at the point 2, 0, is right here, and it gives us a value of minus 2. So we can do better than 0. If we draw the line minus x plus 2y equal to minus 2, this is what we get. So as you can see, if we set minus x plus 2y equal to minus 2, the line also intersects a blue point. If we draw the line minus x plus 2y equal to z, for various values of z, then we'll have parallel lines, right, of different position. And as z decreases, the line will actually go that way. So at z equals 0, we have the first line here. And if z is equal to minus 2, we have the second line here. And if we set z to some even more negative value, it will go down even further. If you take a look at this carefully, well, it looks like we'll reach the minimum possible value for z when it hit the circle right at this blue point. It looks like this is where the z is at the minimum. So this point is 1 minus 2. And the value for z that it gives is minus 1 plus 2 times minus 2 equal to minus 5. So setting x, y equal to 1 and minus 2 gives the minimum value for our problem. Obviously, we solved this using a picture and some might object that this is not a rigorous way of doing things. But for now, this is good enough. At least we can tell where we look for the optimal solution. In future videos, we'll look at how you can actually show algebraically that a solution that you have obtained for a linear programming problem is actually the best possible. Here, our problem is not a linear programming problem because we have constraints that involve quadratics like x squared plus y squared. And integer constraints are not linear constraints. And for now, we'll just be content that we have managed to solve this problem graphically.